Okay, so just to start, this is a silly painting that I started a while ago and then put away. I think one day I was watching the hummingbird outside while talking to my friend about the unique differences between each person's like bedroom when they're a teenager. And I guess I just combined the two and I was like, what would a hummingbird's bedroom look like if it was a wealthy teenager? And I wanted to pack in as many details as I can in this, and I think I could have done that a lot more. But I also find it really difficult to keep track of details when it's still just in drawing stage, you know what I mean? I feel like drawings look more complicated than the finished piece. So it's hard to know when enough is enough or too much. So I think I could have done this a lot more busy than I did. But my general method for dealing with such a full image like this, I did the background first, and I did it more thoroughly than I normally would have, because normally I would do the first layer over everything and then continue from there, but I just didn't want to get lost, especially since some of these things are glass objects that will look transparent, and sometimes I would lose track of little pieces like that and I'd have to fix it later. But where everything kind of went downhill was actually at the very, very beginning. I used this watercolor board. It's done by Canson. It's really thick. It's like a quarter inch thick piece of paper. It's really solid. It's like a canvas board, but for watercolor. However, I would put this product closer to the upper student grade materials. And student grade materials have their purpose. They're amazing for being a stepping stone into a new hobby or a new profession. It's better to be able to make a lot of art in the beginning, as much as you can, in order to learn and get better. And you're not going to do that if every surface that you paint on costs a lot of money. You're not going to spend $30 on a canvas to do your very first painting ever, you know what I mean? You don't necessarily have to buy $20 per tube watercolor paints. I do because I need them to last a really long time so that I feel okay about selling my artwork. I would feel less okay about selling my artwork if I was using paints that have pigments that fade after a really short time, because I don't really think that's fair to the recipient. But if I was making art for myself and I was keeping it, I wouldn't really think twice about it, right? But for the longest time, I didn't really put any thought into watercolor paper, because they're all pretty much acid free and that's what you need to last a long time. So I didn't feel bad about using it because it does exactly what I need it to do. It allows me to use watercolor and it's not going to turn yellow over time. I know that there are some people, it's not super common, who take being able to make beautiful art with really cheap materials as a point of pride. They'll say that it doesn't matter if you have expensive stuff, art is your skills and what you can make of it, and anyone can do it. You don't need to buy things to do it. And for the most part, I completely agree, it's totally true. But I did notice that I would struggle with things, and I didn't understand why. I was unable to make nice, smooth washes. And I told myself that it was just too small of a brush that I was using. And then one day I used a very, very nice piece of paper. I think it was a piece of Arches, and it wasn't even like their best paper, it was their thinnest paper. And the difference in color was just amazing. And suddenly I am able to make smooth washes that I wasn't able to do before. Like, it was not me, it was not my choice of paintbrush size, it wasn't just me not doing it right, it was all just the paper that was setting me back, because I was using stuff like the store brand watercolor papers. Like, I was using all of these little things so that I could spend more money on the paints, because I figured that the paper quality was mostly just about my personal satisfaction, it's about my experience, and for me my experience didn't matter as much, so I always put that part second. And now that I'm using this Canson board for this painting and realizing that it sucks. The paint just sits on the surface, it fades away into nothing because it's not really being absorbed that much. It's not that bad. I'm really happy about how a lot of the colors seem to glow on this because the colors stay so thin on the surface. So I guess there's that. But there really is a big difference, and maybe I kind of ruined myself for trying the big boy stuff, but I super regret doing this particular kind of painting on this particular paper. I think that this one really deserved something a bit more rich and responsive, you know? Or this hummingbird that I set inside a hole in the tree for whatever reason. His little bachelor pad with the racy posters, the aspirational travel ads, the trendy twinkle lights, the taxidermy bees, the jars of preserved flower nectar for the winter, his little bouquet of flowers that his, you know, Instagram fans send to him, glass globes that hold the little dandelion seeds he made wishes on. Anyway, let me know what you think. Did you ever have this aha moment where you tried a really nice quality material and just could not go back to it? Leave me a comment and subscribe. I make new videos every Thursday. Thanks for watching.